ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషద్భ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఃఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 21 ఆఫ్ 10th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ ఆదిత్యానామహం విష్ణు జ్యోతిషాం రవిరంశుమాన మరిచిర్మరుతామస్మి నక్షత్రాణామహం శశీం. As we saw in the last session, Bhagavan Krishna has begun to explain the glory of three lokas. Ihaloka vibhuti, paraloka vibhuti, then purana loka vibhuti. These three vibhutis are going to be explained by Bhagavan Krishna. He has begun from the paraloka vibhuti. Paraloka means the loka, the world which is reached hereafter and which is the base of the earth. Okay. Bhuhu bhavaha suvaha mahaha janaha tapaha satyam. There are seven worlds towards up. Towards up means they are subtler world than the earth. Now this earth, it looks as though grossified world. These equipments, which we call it a body, the device through which we are not able to see those lokas. For us, if we look at the sky, we could see only suns, moons. Suns means only one sun we can see, other suns becomes like a stars. Sun also one among those stars alone. But the sun and moon becomes very close to us. They are very connected with us. But they are connected with even those paralokas. That's the message from scriptures we get it. And both are explained here. I am the sun deity, but I am the Vishnu among all Adityas. Even sun has got one name as Aditya. Now this is the connection, subtle connection. According to our Jyotisha, astrology, the system which we predict the future in the name of Panchanga, Tithi Vara Nakshatra Karana Yoga. So these five amshas, five aspects through which we will predict of our future and present tense. The day begins with a kind of knowledge. For an astrologer, the day begins not only with the sunrise, it has got so many other amshas. He looks for the tithi. Tithi means, is it prathama, dvitiya, and tritiya, and so on up to panchadashi, means paurnimi amavasya. And also the day begins with nakshatra, the day begins with karana, yoga. So all these particulars are not needed for the normal person's life, but all those knowledge are kept with us. Now earth is connected with the universe. This galaxy is connected with one each other. The earth always goes around its own orbit, but it's connected with the magnet of other planets and it also revolves within himself. But an astrologer, not only an astrologer, a normal person should also go and live with Panchanga. The Panchanga is the beautiful method in which you can explore a day with the aspects of these sources, hidden variables. If you are aware about the nakshatra, nakshatra means what? It's one of the stars. There are 27 nakshatras which is influencing the earth through this chandra's chara. They call it the nakshatra saram. So that nakshatra sara means that which the rays, it travels through the moons. Every nakshatra dominates a particular time, period of time on the earth, the being of the earth. This is absolutely, you know, a kind of invention by using the mathematics method. Now, a day begins means for us, the day begins when we wake up, the day begins, we jump into the world, but not preparing ourselves. This is the preparation to face the hidden variables, that which comes in the form of incidents, accidents. If you come to know this tithi is suitable for this kind of activity, if you want to begin any business, so you can begin the business not on Prathama day, not on the first moon day, means after new moon, there is going to be the first moon day, second moon day. That's what I'm just as it is translating from the Sanskrit. Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya, Chaturthi, Panchami, Shashti. And this, you know, we need to have a separate section for it. Then I can explore about our Panchanga, about our astrology and even astronomy. And astronomy is also connected with the maths of human mind called astrology. It's a beautiful method. So this astrology is an evident, this earth is connected with the planets around the earth. Then human being should learn how to live not only the source of earth with the power and capacity of other planets and influence of other planets. If a person becomes aware about what kind of influence, so it's getting now at present, according to that he can manage his activity. So among that astrology, there they divide sun into 12 varieties of sun. That's what I wanted to bring here. Every month sun is named differently, because every month sun, because it's a solar system. Our calendar has got lunar and solar system, Uttarayana and Dakshinayana, a year being divided into two portions according to the sun traveling the path, sun path. Because every day sun rises towards north and towards south, it's known as Uttara Ayanam, Dakshina Ayanam. And according to Chandrayanam, even we also predict a month and divide a month into two, Shukla Paksha and Krishna Paksha, according to the modification of moon. So this calendar says, you know, every month is named because of the moon falls on which Purnima day, according to the nakshatra. Chaitra Masa, Chaitra Nakshatra becomes main nakshatra. In the same way, the sun is connected with that nakshatra. The sun travels, you know, every month one graha to another graha. And whenever he goes the way, according to that, the month also named, the month also is affected. The effect of sun affects the earth. Therefore, every month, we also can understand the difference between the sun of December, the sun of May, June, isn't it? So therefore, there are 12 suns. This sun deity, also known as in the Vedic tradition, the deity which are used for rituals. There are so many rituals. Among those rituals, these 33 deities are very important. Among these 33, the sun god becomes 11 variety, 11 deity. It is considered, though one sun, but according to our Shastra, there are 12 suns. These 12 suns are the sons of Aditi. So Aditi was a mother of this. Even though all devas are the sons of Aditi, therefore they are called Adityaha, the son of Aditi becomes Aditya. The 12 Aditya, because 12 months, you know, 12 Adityas have got their own names. Among these 12 Adityas, one Adityas who was born as Vamana. So he is the incarnation of Mahavishnu. That Vamana is me, who is very glorious among all other Adityas. Okay, I am the Vamana, son of Aditi. Therefore, I am called Adityaha. I am the Aditya who could measure entire creation within three steps. Therefore, I am the glorious Aditya, and also I am the sun deity who is endowed with the brilliant radiance. That's what Amshuman Ravihi. Jyotisham means all the luminous things. Luminous things means what? Natatra suryo bhati na chandra tarakam nema vidyato bhanti kutoyam agnihi tameva bhantamanu bhati sarvam tasya bhasa sarvamidam vibhati. This mantra usually chanted when we show the arati. A pujari with the kapoor, camphor, arati, when he does the arati, but saying the chanting with a particular understanding, so, O God, you cannot be illuminated by sun. The first luminous entity is sun. The sun rays cannot illuminate you. It doesn't have the capacity to illuminate you. The moon doesn't have the capacity. Then the thunder, they don't have the capacity. Then the stars, they also don't have the capacity. Then the fire. Fire means which is shown now. So, but I'm trying with a small, this camphor, kapoor fire, to illuminate to the people how idiot I am. He is not using that word, but that's acceptance of our limitation. That's what called puja. That's a system of puja. In the same way here, he says, Jyotisham Amsuman Ravihi Ahamasmi. I am the sun among all this luminous, worldly luminous object. It means what? I am the Chaitanyam, he said in the last words. I am the sun deity. The sun deity has got important role to play. Okay. Now this sun deity and there are Adityas have been described. Then Marichir Marutam Ahamasmi. Marutam Marichihi Ahamasmi. Before that, we have to read, you know, Nakshatranam Aham Shashi. I am the moon among all the stars. Now he has connected, you know, the moon also one among the stars, but it becomes important one among the stars. As I told you, you know, the Nakshatra Sara, that which is calculated through the moon, the Nakshatra which travels, you know, so the moon which travels nakshatra by nakshatra, it connects earth and the stars. That connection is known as a saram, because the nakshatra influences the earth through the moon. Therefore, moon becomes a valid evident for our astrology system. That's what is known as aham shashihi. Now, all these aspects, you know, when Bhagavan says, I am the sun, when you look at the sun hereafter, you should remember that's nothing but Ishvara. When you look at the moon, it is nothing but Ishvara. So not only in the philosophical level, even in the Vyavaharika level, even in the rituals, the moons are, you know, very important role to play, sun and moons. The day should be lived with sun rays and the night is to be spent with the moon and the moon rays. But what I feel, you know, even the moon is taken into account throughout the day, 24 hours. Therefore, we considered a day is prathama. Prathama means first day. In the first day, the whole day is considered as, you know, inauspicious things for certain rituals. This is a separate calculation, you know. You need to have patience to understand it. Once you understand, my God, our forefathers have given lots of energy which is in the form of knowledge, which can be used like the tablets every day. When you look at the calendar, we are only sticking, you know, with the calendar for the day, the first day of the month to come. The first day, because the salary will be received. At the end of the month, you know, no paisa, no amount in the hand, we should take loan from others. But the calendar has got abundance of knowledge. We have to know how to read them. Every one of us should have the panchanga, and we should also learn. That's very simple. And nowadays, you can even find in YouTube, you know, somebody might have taught that somebody must be respected, you know. We just learn how to bring this knowledge in our life, not with the blind faith. These are all not blind faith, because they are constructed with the force, sun and moon, and movement of all the planets, and connected philosophically, connected also divinely with Ishvara. We should be aware about it. Nakshatranam aham shashi. I am the moon among all the stars. Then he brings marutam marichihi asmi. There is one group, because you know in the heavenly places there are different colonies. So these colonies known as marudganaha. Those species are called marudganaha. So once you get punya phala, you are taken to those lokas and given different shariras, bodies. There you will be called marudganaha. So there are so many marud devatas are available. These marud devatas are 33 in number. The first 33 devatas are 12 adityas and 11 rudras. Okay, 12 plus 11, it becomes 23. And 8 vasus, vasavaha, 8 vasu devatas, then Indra and Brihaspati. So all together 33 devatas, you know, if you know Karmakanda, Shraddha, Tarpana, etc., so you will come to know the usage of these devatas. I consider, so for easy understanding, you can just realize they are the force of the creation. Every force is as named, no? Like we name neutron, proton, electron, like every force is named as the devata. Therefore, when you give tarpana, shraddha, those devatas are located and invoked in the jala, in the pinda. So that is the secret of us. So 33 devatas are karma based devatas, and these 33 marudganas. But this marudgana 49 in number. I said 33. No, 33 beings. So only rudras, adityas, vasavaha, indraha and brihaspati. But here marudganas are 49 in number. So all details are given in Puranas. This heavenly system, it has got its own systematic way of understanding. So in the Puranas, it is given elaborately. Among all these marudganas, I am Marichihi. That's what he brings the meaning. So Marichi becomes a very important devata, because that Marichi alone brings a main fruit for those heavenly life sources. Then the next words, Vedanam Samavedosmi, Devanam Asmi Vasavaha, Indriyanam Manaschasmi, Bhutanam Asmi Chetana. Vedanam Samavedosmi. Now he comes the main topic, because when you talk about all glories, Vedas are become front. They become topmost, superior, supermost entity to be understood. Because Vedas are which are in the form of sounds. The Vedas are not written. In Tamil, there is one word, Yeluda Kiravi, which means that which is not written at all. Therefore, we call it a Shruti. Shruti means that which is always heard. Not written, not read, heard. So when you read, it may go in a day, but when you get knowledge through ear, it remains forever. The best example is Abhimanyu. He says, Vedanam, among the four Vedas, Rig, Yaju, Sama, Atharvan. So among these four Vedas, I am Sama Veda. Now, Sama Veda, why Sama Veda? So it has to be like Yajurveda, which is in the form of Yajna. No, Sama Veda becomes very serious among other Vedas. In the Sama Veda, the Samavedi becomes a Homakunda. For him, there is no requirement of Yajna Kunda, materials. Just for him, he is Homakunda. He can just sit and he can just sing a Samaveda. The Samaveda, the meter of Samaveda, is very much connected with all the sources of the creations. Even when you hear Samaveda, you know, you can feel the vibration. No, I never use the word vibration, but here you can see, we can feel that soulfulness feeling. If it brings innumerable means vibrant changes in your system. Samaveda. Therefore, Ravaneshwara, who became like Ishwara because of Samaveda, he was a Samavedi. Whenever you see a Samavedi, just salute him. Because, you know, Samaveda, if you are able to hear the Samaveda, therefore, you know, you go just into temple to hear Samaveda. After every puja, Devadevottama, Devata, Sarvabhauma, Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka, Chaturveda Priya, Chaturvedam Avadharaya. There, every Vedas will be chanted. So among them, Samaveda will come. In certain places, you know, they will chant only one line. But in many temples, if there are proper Brahmanas are maintained, they even bring Samaveda, means the poem from different places. It will be beautiful. You can enjoy it. Samavedaha Ahamasmi, because that is the core of all other Vedas. Devanam Asmi Vasavaha. Among all the Devatas, means Devas, celestial being, I become Indraha. Indra means he is the chief means he is the captain of all other Devas, celestial being. Why? That we will see in the forthcoming sessions. Indriyanam manaschasmi. Among all the Indriyas, I become mind. Bhutanam asmi chetana. Among all these materialistic aspects, I become chetana vastu. Because we are lacking of the time this session, we will continue the same subject means the portion which is to be seen in the next session tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.